Today we are going to customize some vintage Lesney Matchbox toy trucks I purchased online. I believe they are probably from the 1970s or 80s, possibly, and you can usually find them on eBay for around $10 to $15 shipped. They come in a variety of conditions, but the main thing I look for, other than having all four wheels, is for the plastic windshields to be intact. Unfortunately, on this particular model, the plastic pieces are a little cracked and harder than other models to find intact. So each truck has a single rivet to drill out. Once you drill it out, the components will all come out. In this case, it's the metal body, the plastic windshield, the plastic insert, which is typically the interior of the vehicle. This model has a little guy in the back serving drinks. And the last piece is the base with the wheels attached. I'm doing three of these same Lesney Matchbox trucks today. I'll drill out these other two and then start the paint removal using my heat gun. I'm going to restore these plastic windshield pieces. It's very simple. I just put them in this little glass jar and spray a bit of furniture polish in the jar. They'll remain in the jar saturated in the waxy spray until I'm ready to reassemble at the end of the project. Okay, now onto the paint removing process. Wire brushes, leather gloves, and a heat gun. I start by heating them up for a few minutes to burn the paint. Then I use a wire brush to remove the paint and residue from the body. It takes a few rounds of heating and wire brushing, but eventually it looks like bare metal all around. Here are the other two, the blue ones. I'll heat them up and wire brush them similarly.
awesome.
I like to finish them off with a little sandpaper to smooth out the surfaces. Then over to painting to put on two light coats of white paint on two of the truck bodies, and the third one will have some black on it. So I mask off part of it with tape to accomplish that. After the paint is dry, I like to let it cure for at least 24 hours. It's time to apply some water slide decals. You can find these on eBay as well by searching water slide decals for Hot Wheels. Today I'm making a Mountain Dew soda truck. I will also make a Pabst Blue Ribbon beer truck. And the third one will be a Jack Daniel's whiskey truck. The decals are very small and not the easiest to work with. I use a pair of small scissors to cut out the decals and tweezers to help place them on the truck bodies. Once they are in their desired spot on the truck body, I use a damp paper towel to press down really hard on the decal so it shapes to the contours of the truck body and adheres to it completely. Now it's time to get the windshields out of the jar where they have been soaking in the furniture spray. I wipe them off with a clean rag or napkin, and the plastic is looking very clear now and restored. Time to reassemble with the interior piece, windshield, truck body, and the base piece with the wheels. Here are the final trucks from the project. Please ask any questions you may have in the comments below, and I will do my best to answer you right away. Thanks for watching.